YouTube! It's DruStew, and it has been a while, and I apologize. I got busy doing this one thing called work and trying to pay the bills. And, I mean, YouTube's kind of doing it for me, but got a little slow there for a while, so I had to go announce some cuttings and some ropings, and we're back at it. Hey, today's short little video is going to be about this hand, our left hand. We're not so much going to be worried about this, but what I'm going to do is jump on a horse. I'm going to explain to you why a left hand is so important to our roping, especially our heeling. We'll do this on the head and side here in a couple videos. But anyway, left hand, we've talked about it a little, but our left hand controls a lot of things, especially when we heel. The biggest thing that it does is it allows us to finish a big open heel loop. If we don't finish with our left hand and push our left hand down on our delivery, what happens is we get throwing and pulling our horse like this, our upper body starts coming back, and it doesn't allow us to finish. A lot of times when we do this right here, what's going to happen is we may get tip in there, but it's going to be high on the right, and it's going to come over and it's going to catch that inside leg, and we're going to get that nickel that we all hate so much. So what we're going to do, we're going to get our tip, our swing, our hands are going to be fed close together, and then as we deliver, I want to push this left hand right down here to my delivery. Going back to that deal we talked about on the first video, I'm shaking hands right here. I'm not turning my hand over to get my slack. So when I come in, I'm going to be right down here where I can roll over and get my slack. And then and only then will I lift my hand up a little bit to get my reins and stuff out of the way so I can dally. The biggest thing we're going to work on today is our swing and that left hand. We're going to bring and push that left hand right down there. See when I push that left hand how much tip comes around here? I'm going to do it one more time. Left hand, we're riding our horse right here in the middle of all the business right here, and we bring that hand straight down. That left hand is going to help this rope stand up or go down. We can hold a lot of it. You can catch a lot of steers just by your left hand. It's the biggest thing, finish, push that left hand down there. Rover our steer. Okay, now that's what we're going to show on the horse. It's going to be quick and easy. I've taken the hop out of the heel-o-matic today. It is just going to be standing there. For you guys that don't have a machine, it's just going to be like two pipes hanging there, because I'm not going to be worried about timing. I'm just going to be worried about that left hand and throwing a nice big catch. The more you do this, you'll see that your loops get bigger and bigger and bigger when you rope and start using your left hand to really push down there on a horse. So I'm going to jump on old Cashola right there. We're going to go around here. I'm not going to worry about turning in or anything. This is just about catching and throwing a big, pretty heel loop. And we're going to go do it right now. All right, guys, we're going to be doing the same thing here. And we're not going to be worrying about any kind of timing or anything like that. We're just going to be swinging over the back, up in the front of our saddle. And then when we deliver, we want to make sure we're pushing that hand down. Our horse is going to stop. Then and only then will we sit down, get our reins out of the way, lift our slack up and dally. So that's what we're going to be really working on, pushing that left hand down, and let us finish a big, pretty delivery. As you'll see when I'm riding around here, I'm not going to do anything on the outside. I'm just going to stay right here on the inside. I've got a nice tight little circle. Nice tight little circle. Tips over his back. My tip's over his back. Finish. I push that left hand all the way down there to get my throw. And then I come back and get my slack. I'm going to get my horse in a nice inside position where I can catch. I'm just in a nice trot right here. Hands are fed nice together. Hands are fed. I'm going to come into that delivery, finish with that left hand down, and then come up to my slack. Okay? Get my tip over that target, a little bit to the left, not to the right. Finish that left hand down there. I kind of threw that loop through there a little bit on that one, but I'm still making sure I finish and get a lot of rope down there. Get everything set right, tip over to the left,
over the left, over the left, finish. So guys, what I'm working on right there is doing the same thing. Really what we're talking about is finishing. Now I'm gonna show you how that translates into doing this a little faster. What happens, we get roping these cattle that run a little harder, and we get on a horse that really stops hard, and we get throwing and going for our slack and lifting our hands in a hurry instead of letting everything lay down there and catching those feet. The old saying, let her lay, make her pay, is kind of way outdated, but in an essence it happens here too, just a little bit. We want to reach down, finish with both hands, make sure we complete that delivery and that throw, and then we can come up and go to our horn, get our slack, get our reins and our coils up out of the way. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to get a little bit faster. We'll make the same turn in here, but it's going to be a quicker throw. And I'm going to show you that you can still stay down in it for a long time and just let the heel-o-matic take my slack away a few times instead of coming up here, because I'm really working on both my hands getting down here, finishing into my throw right there, then getting my slack, but I'm going to stay down in it for a long time. So I'm going to be going down the pin. I'm going to get my tip, finish, and then go. Waiting a whole long time for that rope to finish. So this is kind of getting into a whole other left-handed business here, but I'm going to be up riding my horse up, keeping him outside. Feed my hands together, they get the tip over, tip over, tip over, finish. That's going to do a bunch of things right there. When you sit down there and finish, you're going to give your horse an extra chance to stop. I'm not asking Cash to stop real hard. I might here in a couple runs just to show you. But when you do that and finish, it's going to allow you to stay down in your throw, catch that steer, and you'll find that you have more time because you'll have a bigger loop, you'll have more slack, you'll have more time to dally by finishing the right way. It'll give you more time than by cutting it all short and getting in a speed wreck right here. So really work on that. I'm just going to do some runs and let you watch it now, okay? Get my rope up. Keep my horse up here to the outside. Keep him up. Front of my saddle. Tip over, tip over. Left hand is holding my horse up. I'm outside. I'm holding him up. I'm holding him up. I'm holding him up. I'm holding him up. There comes the corner. Long time right there. Whole long time to finish. Get my slack and dally. A little behind, so I got to kick my horse up. Left hand's holding that horse up, holding that horse up, holding that horse up. Bam! Bam! Right there. Okay? Push that sucker down, let that big pretty heel loop, no matter how fast this heel-o-matic's going, if I throw that big loop down there, it's going to give my horse a chance to stop, and it's going to give me more time to dally. Left hand, now the reason I'm doing this out here on the circle is because I don't want my horse cutting in. I don't want him shouldering in, so I've got this left hand holding his shoulder up. He doesn't know when that corner's going to come. I ride, I ride, I ride, I ride. Bam. That's what I'm talking about. A lot of time, even when it's right there and it develops fast, let it happen. You don't always have to rope these things with the hop on. That's why I'm not doing it here tonight. Because one thing, getting your timing is muy importante. But on this, the reason we're roping with it out of not worrying about our timing is so we can just worry about one thing at a time, catching and finishing with our left hand, okay? Of course, you got to work on that timing. I'm not saying don't, but timing's nothing if you don't have a good delivery. So just work on that over and over and over. Reach down with that left hand, finish right there, then go to your slack, and you're going to see it's going to give you more and more time. Do it slow. Start at a trot, get into a lope, and I'm going to finish kind of here doing some fast runs right here, and that's going to wrap it up. So thanks again, guys. Sorry for taking so long. I won't put that much time between videos again. I've got over, I think, 110 subscribers now, and appreciate it, guys. It all happened within a month. So thanks a lot. Tell your friends. Get them on here. Good luck roping this summer. We'll see you soon.